Prior to Carbon Black, I spent 10 years as an offensive hacker for the NSA and CIA. In fact, I like to joke and say that Carbon Black's the first defensive thing I've ever done. And what led to that transition from offense to defense was actually in late 2009, going into 2010, I was working in the Washington, D.C. metro area, and you know, I started to realize that the tools that were available to the defenders just would never, ever capture me or anyone I worked with. When you think about all the tools that were available to defenders or incident responders at the time, they just really weren't adequate to detect or respond to even the most basic of attacks. And so after 9 months of doing these incident response engagements, I basically sat down and with my team and said, hey, look, is this it? And they looked to me and said, yeah, this is what we do. And I'm like, this just is not sustainable. Most crimes today are solved via surveillance camera, where they can just simply press rewind and then hit play. Doesn't there exist a surveillance camera for the endpoint? And you know, all my incident response buddies looked to me and said, no, there's no such thing. We have full packet capture for the network, but you can't possibly have an endpoint surveillance camera recording all activity. That's just too much data. If you had this unfiltered, continuous data set and you had it centrally stored such that it was immediately accessible all the time, this would put the advantage back in the defender's hands, because as soon as we used a new technique, you'd be able to see it because it was collected unfiltered, and you'd be able to say, hey, there's a new technique. You'd be able to share it with all your buddies. And now as the attacker, I couldn't use that technique again because I had sort of exposed myself. So the unfiltered endpoint data is the way that we tilt the benefit back to the defenders, because now we can see everything the attacker's doing.